Rader. I'm here at the Georgeson Botanical Garden at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. I'm with Cooperative Extension Service and Tanana Chiefs Conference. Today we're going to be talking about irrigation options for your garden. So a lot of different options out there. The simplest one is of course just a watering can. But if you have a big garden, or if you have a long ways to go from your water source to your garden, it can take a lot of time to water using a watering can, and they can also get to be a little heavy. You can also just use a hose and a hose connector. You want to make sure you get one that doesn't spray the plants too hard. But the problem with using a hose is sometimes you drag it over your plants, it might not reach your entire garden, and it takes a little bit of time to drag it to all of your different rows. So that can be a little bit of work too. You could also use a sprinkler, but when you use sprinklers, you end up watering everything. Sometimes you end up watering your paths and you get a lot of weeds growing. And with all these three different options, the other issue is that you can't water as deeply and thoroughly as is ideal for your garden. So ideally what you want to do is water your garden really deeply and thoroughly so you get really nicely developed root systems. Also, it's better not to water your foliage because sometimes you get more diseases that way. And so ideally you just want to water your soil and as deeply and as infrequently as possible. So a couple other options are a soaker hose. This works really well just for a couple garden beds, but it can be pretty expensive for a large garden. So one soaker hose that's 25 feet, that might be $10 to $15. So that works really well on a small scale. But for a larger scale, what you want to consider is using a drip irrigation system. So I've got one set up here in this garden, and a drip irrigation system per row foot is going to be your cheapest option. And the nice thing is you can customize it exactly for the size and shape of your garden. So after you plant, you'd want to set it up. And it works really well for a square garden with rows like this. If you have something more like containers or hanging baskets, instead of using drip tape and drip irrigation like this, you're going to want to use individual emitters. And so this one will hook into your main line with this end, and this just drips water into a pot or a container. So depending on your system, you could use both in your garden. You can even set them up on different zones. And those are going to be really efficient ways to water your garden. You'll save water, you'll have fewer weeds, less disease, and ultimately you'll save time too. You can even set it up on a timer system and go away for the weekend. So those are different options for watering your garden, and we'll talk more about drip irrigation in another video. And that's all we have for today. I'm Heidi Rader. Hope to see you next time in the garden.